capitalism, we think that we can answer our own prayer. And so sometimes it becomes even idolatry. And we have to be careful.
That's right.
That we don't make a political party. Mm. That we don't make a government. Mm. That we don't make a person our God. Mm. It's right to honor Dr. King. Mm-hmm. He is a prophetic voice. Mm. It's right to honor those in history that have pointed to Jesus.
Yeah. Right.
But let's not be confused. Mm. Let's always remember that Dr. King didn't point to himself.
All right.
To Jesus.
All right.
And let's remember that's why we're here. Mm-hmm. There's only one King.
Mm-hmm.
And Dr. King, if he were standing here today, and someday we'll stand with him, won't we?
All right.
And when he gets up again, he'll say, "There's the King."
All right.
My name was King, but there's the King.
All right.
Won't that be true?
Yes.
And so let's not stumble on to that side where we get so tied up to a political party or to a person. It's right to get active in our world. But let's be careful we remember the King. But then let's not fall over into despair and sit on our hands and say, "Well, let's wait for the coming King."
All right.
See, that's not right either. That means we're just going to sit and wait for the world to go to hell. We're going to do nothing. Wait for Jesus to come and clean it up. No, when we pray "Thy kingdom come," that prayer changes us. And if we look for the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
And so the tension is between his ascension and his arrival. And we work when we live that prayer.